Boogie, drop that beat. Hi everyone, welcome to my channel, Talking Out Loud with Miss Talkative. Everything I say is my own opinion, alleged, and strictly entertainment purposes. Remember, I'm just talking out loud. Please like, share, subscribe, comment on the video, let me know what you think. Now, in my opinion, Marceau is a condescending B-A-N. I don't know how people can stand to talk to him. Listen to this.
I can only imagine that Stormy's attack on me has been misdirected and interpreted as if I somehow checked her. What are you drinking?
Just water.
You on water right now?
Yeah.
Ain't too much fun?
Nah, I ain't had no fun lately.
That sucks.
Yeah, how was the Black Expo?
It was good. I think had a good turnout. A lot of people came out. Got a lot of positive feedback. So
a lot of people didn't pay $100 though, huh?
From what I heard, one person didn't pay.
Yeah,
my wife, right? Apparently. You know, I'm finna go ahead and get into it.
Okay.
What you trying to check my wife?
Check your wife?
Yeah.
That what you heard?
No, that's what I know.
Sounds good.
You confronting her about $100 about a food.
But ain't nobody saying nothing about paying no money.
Everyone who had a booth, we expected the vendors to pay and the speakers.
So where's the donate that?
Okay, so what? You just said it or did you have it on paper?
We had it on the internet. On the World Wide Web.
You can blame it if you want to.
I'm saying
you can blame the World Wide Web on this if you want to.
I'm saying literally.
Okay, have you been to an event where you can set up in what would be a quarter of the event?
If you're going to charge some, you go ahead and charge it before you even set up.
Ain't nobody said nothing about no money.
I think he said it to everyone.
Ain't nobody said nothing about no money, about $100. But my thing is,
yeah, you always coming for women.
Always. Marceau always talking about the women. But see, what Marceau need to probably do is just worry about Marceau business instead of women business.
You are aware that the Black Expo was my business, and collecting from vendors is part of my business. It's not a free event for multimillionaires to come in and take up 8 sections to sell their product.
Apparently, asking for payment of services is appear to be a trigger word.
Whatever you say, you pissed off.
This was a simple, hey guys, maybe you overlooked this bill.
Go get your wife and talk to my wife about the situation.
You can't be this much of a protector.
Nah.
If you let a man talk to your woman crazy, you a fool.
This is very comfortable handling herself when someone asks for it.
And my wife is too.
Okay, well, not me. Not me.
Somehow.
That's how you did it though.
And you know how you did it.
Stay in Marceau business or men business.
What's shocking to me? A guy would come in and say, hey, you should stay out of women's business when you're literally selling hair care parts for a living to women.
No, I'm talking about business. You know exactly what I'm talking about.
I think you guys are blowing this maybe a little out of proportion.
He should just apologize for the whole thing right there.
No. There's an apology. There's an apology coming one way. And once it comes, I'll receive it with open arms and I'll forgive.
Man, you crazy.
It's the guy that sells hair products for a living.
That's $100 for women business?
No, but that $100, he gave you a tip for $100 for a war.
Okay.
That's on Marceau.
That's 60, though.
That's 80.
Yeah, that's her tip.
There we go.
Don't give them.
I got too many $1 million. We got them worried about $100. But you know, me and Marceau, like, he can't.
Now, Marceau really gets on my nerve. And I was really looking forward to Courtney checking Marceau a little bit harder than he did, or maybe he did and it was edited, because you know we all know, in my opinion, that Carlos gonna protect Scott's 1.0 and 2.0 to the fullest extent. But I guess Courtney, you know, telling Marceau to stay in his place and out of women's business is his way of warning Marceau to leave his wife alone. But Marceau stated Courtney can't be that much for a protector. And I'm like, why aren't you half of a protector for your wife? You have daughters. So when your kids grow up and start dating and stuff, are you just going to sit back and allow men to disrespect them, talk to them any kind of way? They coming in the house crying and you're not going to do anything? And they're going to learn that it's okay to be disrespected by them seeing their mom go through this with you. So when you say you can't be that much of a protector, you need to check yourself. I mean, because this is going to be, this going to come back to get you full circle with your two daughters. And I really hope now, I really hope that they have the backbone that their mom don't have to actually stand up for themselves and don't allow another man or any man to disrespect them. And I hope that they date the complete opposite of you, because you are just so rude and so disrespectful to women. And I mean all women. Because that you were way out of line talking about he can't be that much of a protector. But Courtney, in my opinion, Courtney was right when he stated that Tisha should have been the one to speak to Stormy regarding the business, even though Tisha, you know, Tisha knew it was wrong, and that's why she said no, and she went in the other direction. But I feel as though that Tisha did hold a responsibility at that point, because she should have never let Marcel talk to Stormy alone. And she, because she know her husband, she know that he is an idiot, a douchebag, and he does not respect women. So she knew that it was going to be some type of confrontation, and that's why she went the other way, and she didn't want to speak, because had she thought it was going to go over just smooth and easy, she probably would have went over there and be like, hey Stormy, we it was an oversight, but we forgot to charge you $100. She wasn't expecting Marcel to get that $100, and she know that it was going to be it was going to be some words said. And instead of her being the wife of Marcel and the friend of Stormy, and it was a business transaction, I believe that Tisha should have either stopped Marcel to the best of her ability. Don't do it. Don't go over there. Worry about it later. Don't say anything. And if he headed over there to speak to Stormy, then Tisha should have been right on his heels and not coming in later. I have to be called over to say, what's going on? What you talking about? Like she innocent. No, you knew that your husband was going over to speak to that lady. So whatever they failed to mention prior to the event, it should have been included. It should have not ever been included the day of the event. So they should have had a meeting, and everything should have been broken down in a meeting, itemized for everybody to see. And this includes the new vendors that they added on the day of or the night before, the vendor fees, the space dimensions, anything that would allow them to break the contract that should have already been in place and signed prior to the event by all the vendors and participants, so everyone is on the same page. Marcel talking about everything was on the World Wide Web. Like what? So did he email the stuff to the people, or did he text the stuff to the people and get a response? He put it on World Wide Web where? Because the World Wide Web is huge. That's a large territory to cover. When you say, oh, look on the World Wide Web. Can you be more specific? I mean, like, narrow it down. Where you want me to look at for this information that I'm supposed to know prior to an event that I owe some money, or what my space supposed to be, what's included in my participation, and what am I getting for my participation? Everything included in on the World Wide Web, that's really, really, that was really stupid. I mean, it's like, Marceau, you sound like a clown by saying that. It's like, Marceau, this is what happens when you talk in circles and people don't understand nothing that you're saying. This is why communication, all communication should be in writing. Because don't nobody know what the world you be talking about. You talking about, oh, it was on the World Wide Web. What? Marceau, and you talking about, you keep on attacking people for selling women hair products. But aren't you and your family trying to tap into the women hair products? Y'all trying to sell it? You was at the grand opening when your daughter's hair products went into the store, and we all know only just because they only have two items, you should be trying to brace yourself when you start talking about people selling women's products, because like I said, your daughters are selling it, and so with you standing behind your daughters, that makes you in the hair care business for women. You should be pushing it just as well as them, just as well as their mother. But you dogging out this man. Marceau, you sound like an idiot once again. This is why people don't take you serious. And Marceau, you talking about you ready to receive your apology. What apology are you due when you messed up? This was your event. You messed up. So if I was Courtney, I would have told Marceau, you'll get an apology when the people that you scammed that are all that money get their money back. That's when you'll get an apology. And I wouldn't have paid for no doggone water. I don't know if he did that just to, you know, prove a point to Marceau or whatever the reason behind it, but he wouldn't have got no $100 for no water. Or, I mean, I know he was probably paying it on behalf of his wife for the event, just to let Marceau know, yeah, we got $100. But he would have never got it. He would have never seen it. And he can ask me a million times and I would have gave him a million answers. Get out my face. And that's just my opinion. I'm just talking out loud. Please like, share, subscribe. Comment on the video. Let me know what you think.